We're continuing the series on plantar fascia, and today we're going to look at plantar fasciitis and plantar fascia tears on MRI and what to look for and how to diagnose them. So in this case, we have a number of findings of plantar fasciitis. Let's look at normal first. So this is the central band of the plantar fascia. It's normal thickness, normal signal. But as we come proximally, you can see that the central band enlarges, and it's also of increased signal. So this is not fluid signal. It's a lower grade signal than that. So this is a plantar fasciitis, but not a tear in this area here. Let's go to a different spot. But as we come to the margins, the more medial margin, you can see that there's actually fluid type signal present within the plantar fascia. So we have a partial tear present of the central band of the plantar fascia on the background of a fasciitis. In addition, there is increased signal present within the adjacent fat. So let's look at this region here. So there's increased fat here. You have to be a little bit careful because there are also vessels that run at the margins of the plantar fascia. So this looks like a vessel, but this more diffuse increase in signal, and again here, is in keeping with inflammatory change. Let's keep looking, and we have edema present within the calcaneum at the insertion site, and then we also have a fairly large plantar calcaneal spur. The spur itself is not an indicator of plantar fasciitis. It can be a cause of it because the fascia can be rubbing up against this fairly sharp spur. But if you see just a spur and not the inflammatory changes and the thickening of the fascia itself, you don't call it plantar fasciitis. You just describe the spur. Spurs are easier to see on the non-fat saturated PDs. So this is the spur here. You can see it on the PD fat set, but it's just a lot more obvious on the non-fat saturated sequence.